Now from ABC Studios in Times Square, Amy Robach with what you need to know.
Well, the topic on everyone's mind lately is what to do about this school year, whether you're a parent struggling with the best way to continue your child's education, or you're a school faculty member worried about this new way of teaching. Back to school stress is pretty much unavoidable this year. So here to help ease back to school anxiety is health and performance psychologist and author of Heart, Breath, Mind, Dr. Lee Lagos. Thanks for being with us today, Dr. Lagos. And with the school year looking very, very different this year, we know that kids are experiencing a whole new batch of jitters. So what are some signs that parents should be looking for, and how can they address them?
Absolutely. Everyone is stressed. Parents are stressed. Teachers are stressed. This is not easy for anybody, especially for kids. Parents and teachers should be on the lookout for disruptions in sleep. Anxiety almost always manifests in sleep in kids. So if you're having a child that's having difficulty falling asleep or staying asleep throughout the night, ask them questions about how they're feeling for school. Also, bodily aches, headaches, stomach aches that are happening in absence of any physical illness. And third is sensitivity, increased sensitivity to light, sound, and even clothing. A child may complain that clothing is suddenly itchy or too small. And what they're saying is, I have stress in my body and I don't know how to deal with it.
How do we help them deal with it?
There are three simple strategies that I like for parents and teachers to focus on for helping the kids navigate this new period of going back to school. And there are three S's: self-regulation, sleep, and safety. Teaching strategies such as breathing, increasing exercise, and stretching are great tools for helping kids of all ages to manage stress. Sleep is an important arbiter of stress. If we're not getting enough sleep, whether we're an adult or a child, we're much more likely to experience stress. So implementing those bedtime routines, keeping it simple: dinner, bath, bed, going to bed the same after the same behaviors every week, keeping electronics out of bed and associating the bed only with sleeping. And a priority is creating safety for children to internalize in their bodies, whether that's through healthy daily routines, such as taking off your shoes when you enter a classroom, taking the temperature as soon as you walk through a door, washing hands frequently before each activity. These activities actually say to a child, I'm being taken care of. This is a place that prioritizes my safety.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I have another S for you: socialization. What can parents do when they're concerned, obviously, about their children being socialized during these isolating times?
It is such a paramount concern. Socialization is an actual mental health need for these children. And just like we had to adapt to working remotely, we as parents and teachers have to adapt children to socializing remotely. Now, for some families, this may mean changing the rules about using technology, allowing Zoom communication and calls more, and even allowing the children to engage in more video game supervised play. Other families may choose other options, like increasing phone communication, calls with peers throughout the week, or increasing social engagement in respectful ways, socially distanced ways outside. There is no one size fits all. It's about being creative and very attuned to your child's needs.
No, it makes so much sense. And by the way, congratulations on your brand new book, Heart, Breath, Mind. Yeah. You can learn more about those techniques we just heard from Dr. Lagos to help us all relax and manage stress these days. Thank you so much for being with us and for those wonderful tips to help all of us manage this back-to-school stress.
Thank you.